Welcome to the structural analysis 2 video lecture. So this is regarding matrix method of analysis, and here let us have few more basic concepts before getting into the problems. So before that, in the previous videos I have discussed regarding the basic concepts of matrix method of analysis. So here let us discuss few more important points. The first one is degree of kinematic indeterminacy. So this is usually known, as this is a very basic parameter that every civil engineering student must know to ensure every problem that can be done by them. So before that, let's discuss that degree of kinematic indeterminacy is: a structure is said to be kinematically indeterminate if the displacement components of its joints cannot be determined by compatibility equations alone. So if a structure cannot be determined by static equilibrium equations, that is called as static indeterminacy. And if it cannot be determined by compatibility equations alone, that is treated as kinematically indeterminate. So if a structure is kinematically or statically indeterminate, then arised a variety number of methods to solve different type of problems that arise in structural members, say beams, portal frames, or whatever. That's the point in the second one. That is, for this additional equations based on equilibrium conditions must be formulated to obtain the number of equations necessary for determining all the unknown displacement components. So in kinematically, so that is regarding the displacement. Okay, kinematic regards the displacement only. So for that, there are few number of equations that has to be formulated to obtain the number of equations necessary for determining all the unknown displacement components. So that number of equilibrium conditions, that is called as degree of kinematic indeterminacy, or it is called as degree of freedom. So how many equations are necessary to complete the full analysis of the structure, that is called as degree of kinematic indeterminacy or degree of freedom of that structure. So let's have a small example. For a beam, the degree of freedom is, for free end, is 3. That means if it is a free end, suppose if it is a free end, it can move forward, it can move upward or downward, and it can rotate. That is for a beam. And degree of freedom for a roller end is also 3. And degree of freedom for hinged end is 1. Because it is having fixed support at the bottom, and also it has a horizontal reaction. It has two reactions for hinge end. I'll show now. So suppose this is a hinge support. This is usually called as hinge support, and this bottom is fixed. We have a reaction like this, and also we have one more reaction, horizontal reaction. It can rotate freely about this hinge only. It can produce a moment. So the degree of freedom is only 1, because only one thing can be done using this. And coming for fixed end, it is like this. Right, this is fixed end. This is having one reaction here, one reaction here, and one moment. That means it generates 3 resistive forces, and by that we can say that there is no freedom for the fixed support to move as it requires. So the degree of freedom for fixed end is 0. So these things we have to keep in mind while solving the problems. Yeah. Coming to the next point. So for fixed beam, degree of kinematic inefficiency is 0 because it cannot rotate and degrees of freedom is 0 for that. For a fixed beam it is 0, and for propped cantilever beam here we have only one reaction for roller, no horizontal reaction and no moment. So in two types it can rotate or it can move as it is required. So the degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 2 for a proper cantilever beam, and for simply supported beam it is 3, right? And we have for pin jointed frames we have the formula as degree of kinematic indeterminacy as 2j minus e. This is for plane frames, and 3j minus e for space frames. So what is a plane frame and what is a space frame? This is called as a plane frame. So space frame is nothing but similar, it is something like this. Yeah, this is what a space frame looks. This is a very small figure I have drawn, so many number of more things will be there. So that is what this is, 2j minus e for a plane frame and 3j minus e for space frame, where j is number of joints and e is number of compatibility boundary conditions known, right? So here if you take this as an example, this truss as an example, and treating it as a plane frame, right, treating it as a plane frame because only this figure is shown. If it is in the shape of a 3D shape, if it is in 3D diagram shape, we can treat it as space frame. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 joints, and since it is a space plane frame, the equations of equilibrium are 3, and simply dk is nothing but 9. The degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 9 for this. And for rigid jointed frames, so these are the pin jointed frames. Whenever the joints are there, this is pin jointed. Here it is pin jointed. That means if there is a load here, it can sway in this manner or in this manner. Here also this is rigid and also it is rigid. They can rotate in any of their shape, right? And whereas for rigid joint, they are at the ends. See, end 10, 11 and 12. These three ends are rigid. Okay, so for rigid joint, say for plane frame and space frame, 3j minus e and 6j minus e, whereas for hinge joint, 2j minus e and 3j minus e. This is the formulas for kinematic indeterminacy, right? So treating this as a space frame with rigid joints, so we have 12 joints here. This is 1, 2, 3 story, 1, 2, 3 story and 2 bays, 1 bay and second bay, right? So dk is 3j minus 9, that is 27. So as it is 3 story, we can make this as 3 into 3 and 9 like that. And this is regarding that. And generalized coordinate system. So what is the generalized coordinate system in matrix method? So to know that, the directions are forces, the direction of forces or displacement, they are to determine the structural systems that are known as generalized coordinates. The directions are the displacement to determine the structural systems. So using this parameter, we will determine the structural systems. What we will determine? We will find ultimately the moment. That's what we do in every in every structural problems. Okay, so suppose this is a frame given here. This is single bay, single story frame. So for example, at D, if you observe at D, in flexibility matrix approach, redundant force vector, that means a matrix has to be written here. So the redundant force vector will be VD, HD and MD. That means after finding the reactions at joint D, we have to write a force vector in the first one. That must be a vertical reaction at D, next horizontal reaction at D, and next movement at D. In the same manner, for displacement vector, displacement due to vertical reaction at D, displacement due to horizontal reaction at D, and theta D. What is this? Due to movement, there is no displacement and only there is a rotation, right? That we have to write in flexibility matrix approach. So in stiffness matrix method, the coordinates selected are as shown in the figure. Okay, in the stiffness matrix method, we are selecting the coordinates here. So this is just for the understanding. So that delta is given as theta B, theta C and sway. Theta B is here. This is theta B and theta C and sway. Sway is this. Treating that everything is having same moment of inertia and same length, we get this as sway. And due to this theta B, a moment is generated, and theta C, one more moment is generated, and due to sway force is generated. And when you observe, this is a flexibility matrix approach. Here forces are taken, and here this thing, displacements are taken. Okay, note, in matrix analysis, force means forces as well as moments, and displacement means deflection as well as rotation. So in the first point, we have come across force means force as well as moments. Okay, so if I tell a force of MD, so students get confused. MD means moment at D, but not the force like that. But according to the matrix method of analysis, force means a force as well as moments, right? And displacement means deflection as well as rotation. So this is the case, right? So these are the important points regarding the stiffness matrix, and about the flexibility and stiffness matrix, and the relationship between flexibility and stiffness matrix will be discussed in the next video. Thank you for listening to this video.